Number 10. The name Ghana means warrior king and dates back to the days of the Ghana Empire, between the 9th and 13th centuries. Ghana is part of one of Africa's oldest civilizations, the Ghana Empire. This is a civilization that is over one millennium old. Number 9. The Ghana Empire was built on trade, in salt and gold, which is why British merchants later called it the Gold Coast. Ghana Empire is legendary when it comes to gold. From the times of Mansa Musa's pilgrimage to Mecca to the days of British colonialism, Ghana has been associated with gold. Salt is largely transited through ports of Ghana, from other parts including Mali. Number 8. Ghana was the first country in sub-Saharan Africa to gain independence. It gained its independence in the year 1957. Africa faced brutal colonialism by the Europeans, such that gaining independence was the highest aspiration of any nation in Africa. Under the leadership of Nkrumah, the Pan-Africanist movement established a global campaign that helped liberate the rest of Africa from European colonialism. Number 7. Ghana produces the second most cocoa beans in the world. Cocoa is one of the world's most loved beverage. Chocolate, a product of cocoa, is also one of the world's most loved snacks. Chocolate bars, chocolate cakes, chocolate sweets, and chocolate creams are some of the tastiest snacks. If you are a consumer of cocoa or chocolate, there is a lofty probability that you have enjoyed the sweet, smooth taste of Ghana. As a chocolate lover, the best way to understand this sweet, smooth, delicious substance is to witness its nativity, right in the interior farmlands of Ghana. Number 6. Ghana is the third most peaceful country in Africa, and 44th in the world. The Global Peace Index, released in 2019 by the Institute for Economics and Peace, ranked Ghana as the third most peaceful country in the whole of Africa, with Botswana coming first and Malawi second. It also came in at 44th in the world, with Iceland ranking first. The country would always hold a peaceful transfer of power after elections, which is quite rare in the region. Number 5. Ghana is one of the largest producers of gold in the world. Alongside Ghana's gold production, the country also has one of the largest diamond reserves in the world. Number 4. Ghana is home to the world's largest artificial lake. If measured by surface area, the Lake Volta in Ghana is the largest artificial lake in the world. Construction of this lake started in 1961 with the Akosombo Dam. It was completed in 1965, covering an area of 3,283 square miles and about 250 miles in length. This man-made reservoir can store up to 153 billion cubic meters of water. It became a good fishing ground for its citizens, as well as a major water source for the irrigation of farmlands. The Akosombo Dam generates 912 megawatts of electricity with its hydroelectric power plant and supplies power in some areas of the country. Number 3. Ghanaians love soccer and built a large soccer stadium in the capital of Accra. Soccer is the national sport. Like most West African countries, football in Ghana attracts a fanatic following. In sub-Saharan Africa, Ghana is rivaled only by Cameroon and Nigeria in terms of Soccer World Cup appearances. Number 2. When the country achieved independence in 1957, it took its new name from the Ghana Empire. The word Ghana roughly translates into English as warrior king. Before this, the country had been known as the Ouagadougou Empire for around 300 years. The capital, Accra, also has an unusual translation. It comes from the African word Ankran, meaning ants. It is so called as there is an abundance of anthills in the areas surrounding the city. Number 1. If you are visiting Ghana, you can't possibly leave without exploring Kejisha Market, the largest open market in West Africa. The Kejisha Market in Kumasi has the most diverse array of choices, from the traditional African colorful fabrics and cultural ornaments, to the fruits and vegetables that are endemic only to Africa. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to our channel, Explified.